So the next presenter is J.C. Dilrukshi, design and construction of a low-cost round microscope for identification of chemical compounds, together with S. Jayawardhana.
Raman microscope for identification of chemical compounds. First of all, I would like to give a brief introduction of the methodology and the theory and mechanism behind this experiment, and the results and conclusions obtained from that, and with summary as well as the references. So Raman spectroscopy is a material identification method that can be used in any material. The technique is to get a Raman spectrum from a sample and comparing it against a reference database. It works on both solids and liquids, and more advanced methods like spatial analysis or area mapping can be performed by using laboratory benchtop Raman systems. So the technique is to illuminate the sample from light, and the scattering happens. So that scattered light is contained both Rayleigh scattered light as well as Raman scattered light. We need to insert appropriate filters to isolate the Raman scattered light, and the remaining light is sent towards a spectrometer for the detection, and then we can get a signature spectrum. Usually it's a fingerprint for a particular sample. There are many advantages of this methodology. It's a non-contacting and non-destructive spectroscopic method that can be used in many applications such as forensics, ancient artifacts, drug detection and minerals, etc. And it can differentiate chemical structures even if they contain the same atom in different configurations, like in graphite and diamond. Typically, no sample preparation is needed. Therefore, ideally, field-based applications, and we can analyze through transparent containers and windows. Also, aqueous samples. Water can be used as a solvent, and samples in water can also be analyzed using this method, and it works almost on all materials. So, say a sample is illuminated with light, then the molecules of the sample is interacting with the incident photons, and if the molecule is excited to virtual energy state, and if it is relaxes back down to the same original state, say to the ground state, emitting a photon with the same energy as the excitation photon, then there is no energy difference, no frequency difference, so we cannot use that information to say anything about the sample. And if the molecule is excited to a virtual energy state, and if it is relaxes back down to a higher energy state, emitting a photon with less energy than that of the incident photon, and a molecule can already be an excited state, and if it is excited to a higher virtual energy state, and if it is relaxes back down to the ground state, then the emitted photon will have more energy than that of the incident photon. In these two instances, there is an energy difference, there is a frequency difference, so we call it as a Raman scattering, and we can use that information to analyze samples. So these are some examples for Raman spectra. This is for the spectrum of graphite, and this is for diamond, and for polystyrene. Not that the unique identification lies in the x-axis, Raman's shift values. We are comparing the peak positions, not the intensity. So if you are going to construct a Raman system, then we need to have an excitation source, usually a laser, because we need to eliminate the sample from a monochromatic light, and a sample elimination system and a light collection system, and appropriate filters to purify the less light and to isolate the Raman status light, and also a detector to detect the weak light. So this phenomena is first observed practically by an Indian scientist, C.V. Raman and K.S. Krishnan in 1920s. Their first measurements were done on prism spectrograph using sunlight as the excitation source and eye as the detector. The spectra was generated from sunlight, and later mercury arc lamps were used as the excitation source, and detectors were evolved from photographic plates and nowadays for CCD detectors. This is a picture of their first spectrograph. So we have constructed our own Raman microscope system using these components. We choose the laser line 632.8 nanometers helium ion laser line with 35 milliwatt power. And other components were carefully chosen due to their performance and characteristics and specifications. We have used a USB supported spectrometer from Ocean Optics QE65 Pro as a detector. So there are many geometries, but the easiest and the basic methods are backscattering method and the transmission method. So for the backscattering method, laser light is purified by using a laser line filter. The filter we have used has a very narrow bandwidth and high transmission. And the means to take is there are to separate the incident light into two equal parts, and the a part is guided towards a sample to illuminate it. And the scattered light is collected by a microscope objective, and from that long pass edge filter here, the Raman scattered light is isolated. So the this is the long pass edge filter. You can see that it has a very sharp cutting at the cut-on wavelength and a very smooth and high transmission over the region of the cut-on wavelength. And the remaining light is sent towards the spectrometer. This is the actual experimental setup that we have constructed by using those components and some standard mounts. So using those, using the same components, only the geometry has changed, and we have constructed the experimental setup for transmission method as well. This method is ideal for analyzing liquids, while the backscattering method is ideal for analyzing solid samples. So using those two methods, we have tested few samples, four types of commercially available paracetamol tablets to identify whether there is a difference or similarities, and another solid naphthalene and aqueous solutions like toluene and acetone. So this is the actual raw Raman spectrum obtained for paracetamol, the round tablet. And you can see there is a huge background present. So that background was identified and subtracted by using the Origin Pro 2017 software, and the peaks also identified. Same work has done on other. Same work has done on other paracetamol tablets as well, Panadol, paracetamol and paracetamol. So these are the four spectras together. You can see the shape is almost identical, and the peak positions are, what's most interesting is that the peak positions are exactly same in all spectra. So I took one of them and compared it against a reference spectrum, and it found to be as conclusive. So this is the spectrum for naphthalene and its reference spectrum. And if we are increasing the integration time, then also the Raman signal is enhancing. So this is the spectrum, test spectrum and reference spectrum for toluene and acetone. So as a summary, a basic Raman microscope setup was constructed using a 35 milliwatt helium ion laser and a CCD spectrometer QE65 Pro for two configurations, backscattering method and transmission method. observed Raman spectra are then compared against a reference database and found conclusive and in a good agreement with reference spectra. So as a conclusion, observed Raman spectra are very weak in intensity, therefore high sensitivity detector is needed. See, QE65 Pro has a good detector with relatively high dynamic range compared to other spectrometers available in the market. That parameter is, plays an important part in these kind of applications. So these are my references. And I would like to thank Dr. Sasni Jayawardhana, my supervisor. Thank you.
Questions? I have a fundamental question. You say low cost. Yeah. What is the cost?
Under $750.
What do you mean by dollars?
US dollars. Yes. Normally, a Raman microscope costs like 200,000 US dollars, but we have constructed it under $750, but without the laser and the spectrometer.
Without the laser and the spectrometer?
Yes.
So those two?
Those two available in the department, and we have recently bought a laser for $1,000. Under 2,000 US dollars.
No, you can't say like that, but you have to specifically come up with the numbers. Otherwise, you have to change the topic.
Yeah,
you say low cost, so you have to compare some.
Low cost Raman microscope setup. So the laser and the detector is separate from that. Microscope setup only can be constructed under using 75 US dollars. Yes. Because the experiment were done in a dark room, it should have to be, but still the computer screen, the light from the computer screen affects the measurements.
Okay, so my understanding is that when you see a low cost one, so it has to be a sort of like the round spectrometer you buy. Right, so all these things must be there in one. This is actually an experiment.
Yeah.
That how you do that.
Sorry?
This is an experiment.
Yeah.
So you have all the other things, you get together and perform the experiment.
Yes.
When you say microscope, low cost one, so certain things have to be.
Yes, because commercially available Raman microscope systems are way much higher in cost. Like 200,000 US dollars, or handheld instruments in Sri Lanka rupees 90 lakhs. That's from personal communication. Sir? Yes.
Okay, so as far as I think, you have to. If you design a spectroscope, microscope or whatever, and you have one unit, including everything.
We have constructed the microscope part as a one unit, and we can interchange the laser and components as well, but this experiment were done only to 630 2.8 nanometer laser line. So we can actually fix the laser and the spectrometer to the microscope part.
Good luck.